All right, Shalom Rastafari, Yeshua's Shalom. All right, this is the word for the 23rd, the memorial of the Son of Man, the Man-Child Day. All right, revealing the mystery of the King of Kings and His Christ, the oneness of the Father and the Son, and the revelation as per and according to the scripture. All right, here we go. All right, brothers and sisters, and this is the man child, Lich Teferi, right? Lich Teferi, Mekonnen, the Son of Man. Now, we have been touching on the scriptures. This will be the 120th, right? The 120th, the 120th earth strong, as we call it, of Haile Selassie the First. But more correctly, more biblically, more scripturally, it is the man-child, the birth of the man-child, as per Revelation chapter 12. And then in Christ, in Yeshua, Yeshua spoke of this in Luke's gospel, in John's gospel in particular. John's gospel, and we have John's gospel chapter 16. John's Gospel, chapter 16, all right? So the Son of Man. So let's deal with this. Let's complete this particular word for July 23rd, 2012, all right? I and I, Sister Logical, the community in California, they're going to have at least three ites of what we would call bingi or of thanks and praise. Really, more correctly, would be Miss Ghana. Miss Ghana is giving thanks and praise. So what we want to do at first was go through some of the scripture so we can just keep a foundation of what is the meaning, you understand, scripturally for this season. What is the reason, in other words, for this particular prophetic season that we are in. Now, the 23rd is very important. You'll think concerning the King of Kings and His Christ, and as well as let's get some light on this as well. Let's do some light right here. All right, this is from Christ and His kingly character. This is from the gospel, the good news of Him. You understand? Behold Him. All right, and Abba Kadus and 2012. Right, and some of the mystery from ancient Egypt right there. Very symbolic right there. We did a little lecture a little while ago on that. And now we're here. Now we're here in 2012, and we're approaching that particular time and that particular season. So we want to reason and do a little groundation on it. So this is the part two, and we're continuing. So hopefully you see the part one. So if you're seeing this, please check out part one of this, because we're just going to continue from where we had left off previously. So we left off with on verse 12, where it says, therefore rejoice. So you see, joy is very important. This is why we keep repeating this message of don't allow your heart to be troubled. You understand? Neither be afraid. This is very important, but you can only have that if you're rooted and grounded in the teachings of His Majesty and the testimony of His Christ, our Black Lord and Savior, Yeshua HaMashiach. You know what I'm saying? We're in days and times of great tribulation. You know what I'm saying? And going through even days to come of great tribulation. But Jah loves us, and He has sent His Son, you know what I'm saying, to be I and I light and I and I salvation, even in and through these times. You know what I'm saying? So here in the word, verse 12, it says, therefore rejoice, ye heavens, and ye that dwell in them. Woe to the inhabitants of the earth and of the sea. For the devil, Diabolos, is come down to you having great wrath. He's rotted, Diabolos. Because, why is the devil so angry in this time? You understand? Satan and the Satanists and the Diabolos, they're angry in this time. Why? Because they know, because he know that he have but a short time. He have but a short time. This is where the wars and the rumors of war, the killing and the senseless violence and the evil doing, you understand, is increasing from. Because they know the signs are already there. You understand, the signs are here, there, and everywhere. So here, we're going to verse 13, Satan and Israel. Satan and Israel in the tribulation. You understand? Because the gospel spoke about these tribulations. The prophets spoke about this time of tribulation. Now, in Yohannes Rai, in the vision, the Rai of Johannes of Jah's grace. See, I is saved by grace in faith, through faith. You understand? By grace. We have to understand what this grace of Yeshua HaMoshiach is all about. And it says, and when the dragon now saw that he was cast down to the earth. Now, it's very important when we connect this with the real-time events, such as the fascist invasion of holy Ethiopia, you understand, circa 36 to 41. It's on May 5th, 1941, that His Majesty gave the victory speech, the Independence Day speech, and he says something in there that seems a little cryptic at near the end of it. He speaks about Georgius and how Caduceus Georgius, St. George, slayed the dragon. And then he talks about the dragon. This dragon has newly risen its head. You understand? Has newly risen again and is persecuting mankind. It's very interesting that it's at this day and this time that His Majesty says this, back in 1941. Now, I really wonder what people thought of that. They thought His Majesty was speaking maybe just symbolically, you know, or in a sense. But when you now understand the fullness of the word, you can understand that His Majesty knew what He was saying, and only us now, because we hear about the Illuminati, the dragon, the serpent, you know, and we're beginning to put these things together, but His Majesty already knew those things. And that was a very prophetic day and time and moment. We know May 5th has a great significance, as above, so below. So here we see that when the dragon saw that he was cast into the earth, he did what? He persecuted the woman. Who's that woman? Ethiopia. You understand? He persecuted the woman, the symbolic woman, the nation woman, and he persecuted, what it says, he persecuted the woman which brought forth the man child. He persecuted this woman who brought forward Lich Teferi Mekonen, Lich Tefari Makonen. He persecuted the woman. He persecuted Ethiopia, and by extension Africa, and by extension I, Rastafari, you understand, Ethiopian Hebrews, Beta Israel, you understand, and black people, but in particular, the holy black people, the black people that get it, you know, the Hebrew Israelites, the Ethiopian Hebrews, the elect Rastafari, those who get it, you understand, who get what this is all about. He persecuted the woman which brought forward the man child. And to the woman were given two wings of a great eagle, that she might fly into the wilderness, into her place, where she is nourished for a time and times and half a time from the face of the serpent. And the serpent cast out of his mouth water as a flood. Remember, we began off in part one. We touched on Genesis. We said how to know that what's going to happen in the end if you don't know what happened in the beginning. So we went to Genesis chapter 6, and it spoke about where he says that my spirit shall not always strive with man, for that he also is flesh, and his days shall be 120 years. So now we are at the 120th, you understand, earth strong of the king of Ketamawi Haile Selassie. We're at that 120th earth strong, you understand. So this is also 2012, and they tell us that, well, the Mayans talk about this and that. Well, how interesting these two things somehow correspond. You understand? That's not any accident. You understand? But we have to go to our root and our truth. So the serpent cast out of his mouth water as a flood. So we have the flood is also in that chapter, right? And Yeshua says that as it was in the days of Noah, so shall it be in the day of the Son of Man. You understand? So it's very interesting to make that connection right there. So he casts out water as a flood after the woman, that she might cause her to be carried away with a flood. What kind of a flood? Well, if it's water out of the mouth of the serpent, there's a flood of ungodliness. You understand? And this is kind of like where we're at right now, the lost sheeple. You understand? Caught up in the same sort of doctrine of Balaam and the sin of Balaam and the sin, the heresy of Baal, of Baal Peor. You understand? And all of this immorality, some of it we was touching on here, the four steps of to Babylon, demoralization, destability or instability, causing rebellion or going against Jah's word, Jah's law and order or Torah, taking over or really, in a sense, causing ones to lose control, you understand, to wild out, you understand, which is all part of the Lucifer effect that psychologist Philip Zimbardo, you know, he speaks of in some detail in some of his research, which is out there. Look for the Lucifer effect. Google it, if you will. But then we put that opposite of Christ, right? Opposite of Christ, the four steps of Christ, which is, first of all, morality, right? Then it's stability. He says, deny your what? Self, pick up your cross, right, and follow me, because he is the law. Yeshua is the law made manifest. You understand? He is the living Torah. You understand? And then we will be able to what? Rule, have self-control. But this is how we come to our rulership. This is how the kingdom is restored to Israel. It must be in that order of Yeshua HaMoshiach, otherwise known as the Black Messiah, that the Antichrist, you understand, in one of their main programs, COINTELPRO, they made it known, you understand, that they are Antichrist, because they sought to stop the rise of the Black Messiah, you understand, or the Son of Man, that man-child. So it all makes sense, you understand, and the evidence is here, there, and really, as you can see, it's everywhere. You understand, verse 16, it says, the earth helped the woman. But the earth, and you know, I think about this, I think about the We Are the World thing with Michael Jackson for a moment, you know, where they basically ignored what was going on. But Michael Jackson picked it up from Canada Media, and he used his own star power, as it were, to gather momentum and attention from the world. So they're singing the song, We Are the World, We Are the People, We Are the One, you know the song, right? And he brought that attention. It's almost similar to this, where it says the earth, it helped the woman, right? And the earth opened her mouth, right? Opened her mouth and swallowed up the flood, right? The flood which the dragon cast out of his mouth. I'm not saying that's the only manifestation of this, but I'm seeing that as a sign in this, all right? And just sharing it with my brothers and sisters. Last verse, verse 17, to complete this chapter, chapter 12, of the book of Revelation, or Ye Yohannes Rai, the vision of Yah's grace, the vision of the grace of Jah. It speaks about here of the Jewish remnant, or the remnant of the true black Jews, the Beta Israel, Ionai Rastafari, and the Ethiopian Hebrew people, the once lost but now found Beta Israel. It says, and the dragon, the Drakos, was wroth with the woman. The dragon was wroth, was angry with this woman. It's interesting. Ethiopia was first then, but it's like the last today. You know, first shall be last, but the last shall be first. Overstand that right there. So the dragon was wroth with the woman and went to make war. See that war there? Went to make war with the remnant of her seed. Remember in the earlier reasoning, we were talking about the seed from Abraham, and that seed is that black seed. Went to make war with that seed. Also the spiritual seed, which kept, notice this, which kept what? Went to make war with the seed, the black seed, which kept the commandment of God, which kept the commandment of Ha Elohim Baruch Hu, and have the what? The testimony they bear witness to. You understand? The witness, the testimony of Jesus Christos, the testimony of Yeshua HaMashiach. All right? So that's where we're at in that sense right now. We're this remnant. You understand? We're this remnant. Where's the picture right here, the iconography? You understand? If we're the remnant, you understand, of her seed, you understand, we're the remnant of her seed. You remember, and this also connects us once again with the genealogy of Isis or Genesis, where you read in Genesis chapter 3, you understand that there will be a seed of the serpent, a race of the serpent, you understand? And there's a seed of the woman. And the seed of the woman is that man-child, right? And that man-child, notice how the serpent would bruise his heel. That means his steps, his progress. Where His Majesty wrote in his autobiography, my life, he would tear na Ethiopia Arimja. In other words, my life and Ethiopia's progress. We see how the serpent has tried to bruise his heels, the progress of the new Ethiopia, the work of His Majesty. But what does it say concerning the seed of the woman? The seed of the woman shall bruise the serpent's head. You understand? That's the mission, my brothers and sisters, in Yeshua HaMashiach, to the glory of Kedamawi Haile Selassie, to the glory of Hashem Haile Selassie the First, is to bruise spiritually and in reality that head of the serpent. So we see a connection from Old Testament to New Testament, but her seed is not just Ethiopian. Her seed is not just black people. It's very clear from the scriptures right here. Her seed, page flipped over, her seed is the remnant of her seed, the remainder of her seed, you understand, the remnant, the kereta of her seed, which keep the commandments of God. You understand, the commandments of Jah. So that means, you see the connection right here? Lawfulness. You understand? The commandments of Jah, and have the testimony of Jesus Christos, or the testimony of Jesus Christ, which is the gospel of Him, the good news of His Imperial Majesty. So we have to recognize what the qualifications, not just because one is black. A lot of folks who are just caught up on that, it's almost like the hate produce or something, like, since white men come with white supremacy, some people, black folks, try to get even with the white man. When you get even with a devil, you just become a dumber devil. You understand? It's not for us to get even, you understand, with the white man. You understand? It's for us to be conformed, you understand, to Abba's Son, to Yeshua HaMashiach in spirit and in truth. So this is just a little word for the 23rd, you understand, a little word for the 23rd, and once again, hail up and big up Logical, you understand, I and I brothers and sisters out there, and Sister Echite Emmanuel, you understand, beat the drum, right, for HIM's 120th, you understand, his 120th, beat the drum for his story, for I and I, true story, for His Majesty's 120. So it's the Logical Youth Unit that are going to be having some presentations, as well as they're going to be drumming for these three lights and ites, as well as Psalm 83. And there's some psalms we wanted to touch on as well in this particular word right here, since we have about a light or so, you understand, meaning a day or so, you understand, perhaps just a day. So we're just trying to get through this, some of the basics right here, and hopefully we'll be able to go over whatever we might have missed. What a feat. And that means in the forwards. Now, let's deal with some of the psalms. Some of the psalms that should be chanted, should be intoned, not really sung. Remember, the Psalms are chanted. It says chant a psalm. Not so much sing a song. That's a whole different order. Sing a song. You know that one right there. That's something else. That's a different order. And to I and I order, that come like disorder. And it is disorder. Now, there's a word here in the scripture, pray the I. Let me just get my the concordance right here and just find this particular word right here, where it says to give praise, and I find this to be so very important, to give praises, or as we say, Isis, Rastafari, but in Amharic, we say Miskana. Miskana means thanks and praises, and the Mezmur, which is translated as the song, the Mezmur is really the chant. It's chanting, these psalms. The psalms are chiefly to be chanted. So let me just look up praise for a moment right here. Give me one moment, my brothers and sisters. Praise, praises, right? It says to give praise, to give praises. Actually, I think it's to give praises with overstanding, to give praises with overstanding or with understanding, it says in the King James version of the Bible. Let's see, sing praises, it is good to sing praises, show forth his praises, to give praise with understanding. Okay, praise. Yeah, it says praise most frequently used with regard to praise rendered to God. The verb is frequently changed in the revisions to bless, in the revised Bibles to bless or to give thanks. To bless or to give thanks. So we want to touch on a couple of the Psalms. One is 83. 83 is a very, especially for this particular time and season. You understand? 83. And also the Psalms of Ascent. The Psalm of Ascent begin actually with 120. So Psalms of Ascent begin with 120, and I think it completes at 134. It's 15 Psalms. And these are the pilgrim Psalms. These were usually the Psalms which were chanted or intoned as ones went up to the holy festivals, and to the feast of Yahweh. And it's interesting, if we have the opportunity, we'll touch on some of that right now. Let me just find this right here to say with understanding. Let's see. Yes, sing ye praises with understanding. 47 and 7. Let's go to 47 and 7 as the opening of this. So this is for the 23rd, just to kind of I mind, brothers and sisters. Now, it says to beat the drum. You know, usually we beat the drum, you understand, or the harps, as we call them. If one doesn't have the harp, so even if one does have the harp, remember the principle of the harp is the heartbeat. You understand? And the heartbeat, do good, do good, do good. You know, that's that heartbeat. But that's the heartbeat that's at peace. You have to understand that. That's the heartbeat at peace. That's why we began off saying what Christ said in John 14 and 1, let not thy heart be troubled. You understand? And this is what where this is truly spirituality. Yes, we read it. Yes, it might seem to have a religious aspect here or there, but the true spirituality is when you really eat and digest that word and understand who he is speaking to and you receive it. We are not to let our heart be troubled. You understand? We are to rejoice. We are to have joy and to rejoice. That means you can't let Satan, the devil, see, the devil, Satan, doesn't have any power. The Kibbutz Neges taught this, teaches this very well, and speaks about when the fallen angels or the angels took on flesh, or they were given flesh. And the whole thing about the whole Satan thing is that people think that Satan is fighting against God. Satan has been disobedient and violated what the, you know, what God has ordered, and that was that all the angels would bow to Adam. You understand? In a sense, to bow to the black man. Satan said, nah. Satan said, I'm greater than him, so forth and so on. And if you give me leave, me and my angels will prove that we are better. If we had flesh and blood, we'll prove that we are better. Because Jah made man, Adam, who was a son of God, he was to be the God or the ruler, you understand, the Meri, or the Khalifa, so to speak, of the planet Earth. And Satan did not like that. So really, what Satan's whole job is to do as a prosecutor or accuser, you know what I'm saying, is to find fault. You know what I'm saying? Just as it would be in a court case, you know what I'm saying, to find fault before the judge. And the book of Job is a good example of what takes place within those heavenly courts. And it's very important to understand that, because some people have this false idea that so-called it's good and evil is on an even keel. No, it's not. Good is always over evil. But in man's heart and mind, Satan has confused him, has hoodwinked and bamboozled us by many different schemes and stratagems over the past six or so, some say 1,000 years. All right? So let's understand this right here. First of all, Psalm 47. Psalm 47 is very interesting right here. Psalm 47 says, "Oh, clap your hands, all ye." First of all, it's to the chief musicians, a psalm for the sons of Korah. Now, we've touched on Korah recently in the Sabbatical Torah portion, reading and feedings, but this is one of the psalms for the sons of Korah. And there's a very interesting backstory on that. But right now, let's just get into this psalm of praise. Oh, clap your hands. Oh, clap your hands, all ye people. Shout, Jah, Rastafari. Shout to God with the voice of triumph. But in the Ethiopic sense, this shout would be what's called a ilta. And you probably have heard it before. It's only done perfectly, really, among the true original Ethiopic peoples. Other Arabic and Middle Eastern peoples do it, but they do it in a different form. It's called ililta, right? And the ililta more or less would go something to the effect of like in a falsetto sort of voice. That's when it's about the exaltation, the lifting up, the ililta. You'll send the that's the shout. On that level, you will see it on in that sense. I wanted to put that out because you hear it, but we'll bring it together, Jah willing, in the teachings. For Egziyahir, the sustainer, Le'ul, Most High, is terrible. Is terrible. He is a great king. A great king over all the earth. He is a great king. He's even the king of kings. Yahweh, he who is who he is, he is that great king over all the earth. He shall subdue the people under us. So who subdues these people, these heathen and sheathens? Is it us? Is it the amount of money we have, the amount of guns and weapons and ammunition? What subdues them? It's Jah who will subdue them when we come into conformity with his will. Keep the commandments of God and the testimony of his blessed Son of Yeshua HaMoshiach, of Jesus Christos. He will subdue the people under us, under I and I. They won't be able to help themselves. And the nations under our feet, under our feet. You know what I'm saying? So Christ is the Ras. He is the head. We are that body or the church. You understand? And everything is subdued, the nations are subdued, put under our feet, which is to say under Christ's feet, under the feet of the church. He shall choose our inheritance, and he has chosen our inheritance, our divine heritage for us, the excellency of Yaakov, whom he loved, Selah. Egziyahir, the sustainer, is gone up with a shout. He's gone up with that ililta. Exiyahir Sustaina with the sound of a trumpet, with the sound of even the shofar or the ram's horn. Sing praises to Exiyahir the Sustaina. Sing praises. Sing Misgana. Sing thanks and praises. Sing praises to our King, to Negusachin, to our King, the King of Kings. Sing praises for Exiyahir the Sustaina. Elohim is the King of all the earth. Of all the earth, the King of Kings is the King of Kings. You understand? Of all the earth. Sing ye praises, and this is the key right here. Highlight this in your Bibles, if you will. Sing ye praises. Y'all sing praises with understanding. You see, a lot of times one may sing praises, but don't overstand. So the word, sound, and power doesn't have the ultimate effect. You understand? Because if you don't understand it, the devil, Satan, can throw doubt. Remember, he has no power. All he has power to do is to germinate a seed, a thought. And that thought is to doubt. You understand? To believe him, to accept him, to have confidence in him, but to doubt Jah's word and to doubt those whom Jah has sent and to doubt the clear and the heavy, heavy evidence. Exiyahir reigneth. The King of Kings reign over the heathen, over the Goyim. Exiyahir sitteth upon the throne of Kedisanao, of his holiness. He is set apart. You understand? He is not in the category, you understand, of these other kings and rulers. That's why in the time of his imperial majesty, there was a bunch of kings at first, and all of them got vonked out, with the only exception, really, of any consequence, besides those in the Arab world, and they're not really real kings anyway, in the Arab world. They just like, you know, they like to be, you know, Ishmael. You know how that goes. Anyway, is England. And I think that's just because of, you know, that covenant, you know, that gracefulness of the King of Kings, and perhaps because of the last-minute assistance that they finally had gave, you understand, to Ethiopia, like they should have given it from the beginning. You understand, speaking about the fascist invasion. Verse 9, it says, the princes of the people are gathered together. The princes, the rasses of the people are gathered together. Even the people of the God, Amlaka Abraham, the God of Abraham. For the shields of the earth belong to Exiyahir Lotu Sabhat. He is greatly exalted. He is greatly to be lifted up. You understand? To be made important, because Haile Selassie the First is important. More important than any of this rubbish and garbage they be talking about. If they only paid attention to the teaching of His Majesty, the world would not have become so goddamned awful. But it is written, you understand, and they chose. Jah prophesied, and they made their choice. You understand? They could have looked at the word and chose differently, but they chose what they chose. You understand? So here we are. So let's deal with Psalm 83 for a moment. Psalm 83 is a very important psalm for this 120th, as well as the 15 psalms, of the Song of Degrees. You see, the Song of Degrees are the songs that are usually intoned and chanted during the pilgrim festivals, going up the songs of ascent. They're also called, as we ascend up to Mount Zion, as we ascend up the heights, as we make higher heights, you'll send physically going up, but now spiritually, you'll send for I and I, even in this present time, it is spiritual heights. You understand, of joy and rejoicing in these psalms. When we chant these psalms, as Psalm 47, verse 7 says, sing ye praises with understanding, with overstanding. Comprehend what you're saying so that the word and the sound will have power, force, and effect. You understand, to manifest the will of our Father in the name of our Lord and Savior, Yeshua HaMoshiach, Jesus Christo. So let's get into this psalm right here, Psalm 83. It's a song or psalm of Asaph, This is Ma'awad Memphis Kedus, Ahadu Amlat. Keep not thou silence, O God, Abitu, I father, his father, Yeshua's father, O father of the house, father of the house of Christ, man, Beta Christian, and with the new name, father of the house of the Beta Rastafari. Hold not thy peace, be not still, Abitu, for look, thine enemies make a tumult. Look at all the enemies, the haters of his majesty. Look at the tumult they are making in the earth. Look at the wars and the devastations and the bloodshed. All the enemies of our God, Father, and King of Kings. Thine enemies make a tumult, and they that hate thee have lifted up the head. They've lifted up their dirty heads, Yovs, and to try to make themselves of more excellency than his imperial majesty. But they've only lifted up their heads so it may be chopped down. They have taken crafty counsel against thy people. See, they're taking crafty, you know, we find these things out like the Tuskegee experiments, and it's just a couple of things. Medical apartheid, you understand? You know, so many kind of little crafty, some even say the whole AIDS thing against the black community, against the Africans, is also a part of that crafty counsel they have taken against thy people and consulted against thy Kedushan, against the hidden ones. Those who are set apart, the holy ones. Verse 4, they have said, this is what the heathen and the sheathen and the Babylonian, the Goyim, they say. They say, come. You know, they call a gathering among all the Goyim and the heathen. Come, let us cut them off from being a nation. See, they don't want us to recognize, got to bring this forward, they want to recognize I and I true nationality. You understand? As Ethiopians, as Ethiopian Hebrews. They want us to be Negroes, blacks, and coloreds, 13th and 14th Amendment persons. Then they own us. You understand? Then we are made over as their property. They don't want us to be a nation. This is why they have set so many stumbling blocks in the way of the Ethiopian World Federation. You understand? This is the reason why these things are the way they are, if you understand them prophetically. You understand? And they have rejected, let's just show this right here. They have rejected, you understand, those whom his majesty has sent, like this brother, our late brother right here, Dr. Gladstone Robinson. You understand? And some of these brothers right here, they know. They know the truth. You understand? We better admit the truth before it's too late. You understand? Because time, you understand? You know, time is on our side, not like that song there, but time is on our side, but time is not for those who are skylocking, you understand, and loafing and joking, you understand, about this, you understand, and a word to the wise should be sufficient. You know, you rebuke a wise man, he'll love you. You rebuke a fool, and he'll hate you. So those who hate this ministry, we understand. You understand? It's your foolish heart. You understand? Because the fool has said in his heart there's no Jah. Because Jah's word is in your heart. You understand? You would love I and I. You understand? You would recognize what time this is. They have said that the heathens, the enemies of the King of Kings and his Christ, they have said, come, let us cut them off from being a nation. From being a nation. You understand? A nation. A real nation. We as Ethiopian Hebrews, Beta Israel, a real nation, not a hip-hop nation. What kind of garbage? You know, a lot of joking. People crack smoking here. You understand? That the name of Israel, what name? The name of Israel, what name? The name of Israel might be no more in remembrance. They don't want to remember that Israel is black. That's what they, you know, this is where a lot of the confusion in the world it comes from. They want to cut us off. You understand? And then somebody want to identity thief us, theft us. You know, they want to be a thief, you understand, from us. So they want to cut off this name, the name of Israel. You understand? No longer in remembrance among us. No, you're not Israelites. Y'all are Negroes. No, you're not Israelites. Y'all are blacks. No, you're not Israelites. Y'all are colored. No, you're not Israelites. Y'all are African American. Oh, well, we're the whole continent, you're saying African American, the whole continent, Africa? For real, for real? They're joking. You know what I'm saying? And most of y'all are joking because you don't want to recognize this revealed truth. Verse 5, for they have consulted together with one consent. Don't we recognize that it's like almost like all the nations have been in conspiracy against the Beit Israel, even to this very day and time? You know what I'm saying? That besides the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, and one another, we are all that we have. You know what I'm saying? Don't we recognize that they have consulted together with one consent? They are confederate against thee. You know what I'm saying? They don't know how to operate a federation. They are confederate. You understand? They are confederate against thee. Against thee. It's not even I and I. You know what I mean? The battle is the Lord. The battle is Jah's. It's not I and I's. The tabernacle. Now, who are these? Now, let's note these right here. The tabernacles of Edom, the Edomites, right? And the Ishmaelites, you know, the so-called Harabs, you understand? No, the Arabs, right? Of Moab, you understand? Moab, the people of incestuous, relate the people born of incest, in a sense, Moab, right? And the Hagarines, remember, Hagar was the mother of Ishmael. The Hagarines, she was an Egyptian, right? There's Gebal, right? There's Ammon. There's Amalek, you know what I'm saying? And these names, if you get an opportunity and you have the Metaphysical Bible Dictionary, you could download it from our website, lojsociety.org. Go to the study page and you could download it in a PDF form. Look up these different names. Look up, when you see these biblical names, look them up. Find out what's really in this name. And on a metaphysical level, because it's on the spiritual level, so not only do you know in history who they are, but also in the spiritual mechanics of this so-called matrix, who they are. The Philistines. The Philistines, right? The Philistines with the inhabitants of Tyre, the coastal people, the sunbathers. You understand? The coastal people, Tyre. Remember Tyre and Sidon? Remember that woman that Yeshua had met? She was a Syro-Phoenician, right? And then they said that she was from Tyre in another gospel. So, but she was a Gentile. She came to Yeshua, and Yeshua didn't even speak to her. He said, it's not for me to give the children bread to dogs. She was like, truth, Lord, I'm a bitch, but, you know, the dogs even eat that which falls off, you understand, the master's table. You understand? And what did he say? He said, oh, daughter of Israel? No, he couldn't say that. She wasn't one of us. But still her faith, you understand? He says, be it unto you according to your faith. It's a very interesting part right there, but that's just a little bit of the background. So when you see the word, it becomes like 3D. It becomes real. It is reality, but it can become real to you. You can see it. Your eyes are open to it. You're not stumbling around in broad daylight no more. Verse 8 says, Asur or Asher, those are the Syrians. You know, the Syrians are up in the news, killing each other. You know, from the Harabs. And I say, wait, if they're doing that to themselves, can you imagine what they did to us to run us out of our homeland? Wow. Asher also is joined with them. Asher, they all join up. They all join up. You know what I mean? They have hoping the children of Lot. They have helping. They are help to the Sodomites. That's what Lot. Lot of Amarinya is one of the old words that used to be used for a homosexual. You know, Lot, like Lowit. Lowit means to change, like a change. Lot, right? The children of Lot. Selah. Selah. Meditation. Meditate on this. Verse 9 says, do to them. You understand? So this is the chant. This is the chant for this 120. Do to them as to the Midianites. And it's interesting because we're in Torah portion 41. And we see what happened with the Moabites and the Midianites, how the king of Moab, Balak, right, how he hired a sorcerer. I mentioned sorcerer. One had commented, I think it was Wyndham Lonnie, had asked, well, what's the proof that he's a sorcerer? Well, why was he hired to curse? What was he? He wasn't one of our prophets. You know what I'm saying? What was he doing? What was up with all these altars and all these sacrifices? What is all that about? That's part of their magic right there. That's part of their sorcery right there. You know what I'm saying? But we'll get into that in a little more detail. But it says, due to them as to the Midianites, because right after the sin of Baal Peor, after the sin of the strip clubs, You understand? After the sin of the shit hop, hip hop, and hip hop Babylon. After all of this, when the traitors, when those who worship false gods, when they were cut off. See, the difference with us right now is that we have not cut off these people, and these people are now terrorizing the so-called black community and the remnant of the Beit Israel. But it says, due to them as to the Midianites were crushed. You understand? We had a battle against them. We crushed them, as we will crush them even spiritually again, and physically if necessary, but this is a spiritual warfare first and foremostly. As to Sisera, as to Jabin at the brook of Kishon. So this is all this background to this in the scripture. And it's very beautiful when you are chanting the praises with understanding, when you really know, well, what happened to the Midianites? What happened to Sisera? What happened to Jabin? What is this place, the brook of Kishon, all about? Which perished at Endor, or Endor. Endor, right? Endor, the fountain of the forest. Endor. They became as dung. You know what dung is? Dung is shit. Dung is doo-doo. You understand? That's what dung is. You understand? Dung. They became as dung for the earth. They became like doo-doo for the earth. You know, they became like fertilizer, in a sense, for the crops that we need to grow in the new millennium. Make their nobles like Oreb. Their nobles, all of their pompous asses that call themselves leaders and all of this other kind of stuff, and call themselves nobles, and, you know, and people bow down and treat them like something while they blaspheme his majesty. Well, make their nobles like Oreb and like Zeb. See, you need to look up. If you chant this, you need to chant it with understanding. Go look up Oreb. Who's Oreb? Who's Zeb? Because if you're saying this and you're chanting it and you don't and you're ignorant, it doesn't have any effect. You know what I'm saying? Yay, all their princes as Zeba. Who is Zeba? And as Zalmunna. Who is Zalmunna? Do not chant unless you chant with overstanding. It's the first thing you need to do is read through this. You understand? Study this. You know what I'm saying? And then even, you know, if you're in a good scope for your Bible, it has footnotes. You got internet. You can search this out. It's kind of very easy to at least get a basic idea. Verse 12 said, who said, these all said, let us take to ourselves the houses of Jah in possession. This is the same thing they have done. They have taken Jerusalem. They've taken Mecca. They've taken Egypt. You understand? They've taken the houses, you know, the holy lands, into their possession. You understand? And to tell the truth, they're trying to take Ethiopia while you're wandering around the wilderness trying to find a better apartment, trying to find a better rat trap. You understand? But anyway, it says, who said, let us take to ourselves, let us, you know, let us steal from the Beit Israel. They wanted to take our holy places, take the houses of God into their own possession. Oh my God, Amlake, Elohe, you understand? Make them like a wheel. Make them like a wheel. We're going to roll them around. As stubble before the wind, as the fire burneth a wood, and as the flame setteth the mountains on fire. So we see a lot of natural kind of, what they call it, disaster. There's fires all over the Midwest and everything. There's all these kind of natural disasters going on around the world, because a lot of these people have to leave our holy lands. If they don't leave one way, well, the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof. So persecute them. Persecute them. Remember, this is a prayer to our God Father in the name of Yeshua. You understand? Persecute them with thy tempest. All these kind of cyclone. They said the other day there was like 1,000 of these came down. I was like, wow. Persecute them and make them afraid. I'm so afraid to sound like a freight train. Make them afraid with thy storm. Fill their faces with shame because they walk around too proud. You understand? Like their dung don't stink, right? Persecute them with thy tempest and make them afraid with thy storm. Fill their faces with shame that they may seek thy name, that they may seek the Hashem, that they may ask, well, what does Kedemawi Haile Shalasi mean? You understand? Who is the first power of the Trinity? You know what I'm saying? O Lord, I bid to our father, his father, O father of the house, make them be confounded. Make them be confounded. Make them be confused. You understand? And troubled. They should be troubled for how they have treated our God, Father, and the King of Kings, how they've thrown the word of life behind them for Satanism. They need to be confounded and troubled forever. For as long as they want to hold on to that abomination. Yea, make them be put to shame. Because, see, they're not going to just be shamed. They have to be put to shame. You understand? And perish. And perish. Done with it. The earth is the Lord's, the fullness thereof. So if they don't recognize the Lord, Jah, even our black Lord and Savior, then they need to leave. They're violating the terms of residency. You understand? Let's recognize it like that from the higher law. The higher law. The higher law than all of their man-made laws. Right? That men, that humanity, that the Goyim, you understand, and the lost sheep that want to live in the image of the beast like Goyim too, that they may know. See, because when we're teaching them and showing them the word, they act like they just don't know. So we pray this, we chant this, you understand, that they may know that thou, that the I, whose name alone is Yahweh, and that means he who is who he is, even the King of Kings, art the Most High, that you are the Most High over all the earth. Amen and amen. Now, one more psalm that we're going to touch on right here, you understand, even though we would love to even get into that in a little more detail. I know, brothers and sisters, that many of y'all would love that too, but we left a lot for y'all to study, you understand, and the Holy Spirit guides you into all, you understand, into all knowledge. It says that the Holy Spirit shall teach us all things, you understand, all things. So you must trust that word of the King of Kings and Christ, especially as brothers and sisters, as newborns. And if you're not newborn, then you better consider, you understand, be born before it's too late, you understand, be born again from above before it's too late. Receive this word into your spirit, soul, you understand, so it can renew even in the right time your body. Psalm 120, which is the first of the Song of Degrees. Now, during these 3 days of light and during such high holy days and times such as this, the man-child, right, the earth strong for the man-child, Lich Teferi, it's very important for I and I to chant these particular songs of degrees. Now, literally, it's of ascents, of heights, right? Perhaps it says down here in the footnote of the Schofield Reference Bible 662, page 662, it says, perhaps it was chanted by the people as they went up to Jerusalem, 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 right, to the feast, to the high holy feast, right? And so that's a kind of a yema'erig, you understand, of ascent, of lifting up, you understand? But it's not just a physical act. Remember, it is in spirit and in truth. So when we gather together, you understand? So if one doesn't have the drums, then stay in the heartbeat, you understand? Stay in the, keep your heart, you understand? Let not your heart be troubled. You understand? Remember Yeshua's peace. You understand? He says, his peace he gives to us. Not like the world gives peace. You know, they talk about, oh, they have a new peace treaty. And then more people die afterwards. So we don't want that peace. You can keep that to yourself. You could take that to hell with you, that kind of peace. You understand? But Yeshua's peace, you understand, is his peace. You understand that he gives us. He says, make not your heart be troubled. Neither be afraid. All right. So here in Psalm 120, it says, "I cried to Yahweh, and He heard. Deliver I soul. I be to I father, His father, or father of the house, from the lying lips." And from a deceitful tongue, What a very apropos psalm for days like these, ain't it? Verse 3, it says, "What shall be given to thee? Or what shall be done to thee, O thou false tongue? All the lies and the slander that they have uttered against this righteous man, against Ketamawi Haile Selassie. We chant against these false tongues. You know what I'm saying? These false tongues, these liars, the blame Haile Selassie crowd, Gentile, careless Ethiopian, stupid niggers. We don't really care. You understand? Basically, all those who have lied against our Father, this psalm is for you. You understand? This psalm right here is for you. What shall be done to thee? You understand? What shall be done to thee? You understand? What shall be given, really? What shall be given to thee? Or what shall be done to thee, thou false tongue? It says, sharp arrows of the mighty, the word, sound, and the power. You understand? As we beat the drum, as we chant, you understand, thanks and praises and psalms and mezmur, right? Sharp arrows of the mighty with the coals of juniper. You understand? Fiery. You understand? The word is fiery. The word, sound, and power. Right? It says, woe. Woe. Woe yo is I. Woe to I that I sojourn in Mesech. In Mesech. Right? That I dwell in the tents of Kedar. Now, if you look at Mesech and Kedar, right, or Mesech and Kedar, as some say, but Mesech and Kedar, you understand, you'll find that they're part of the Arab, you understand, the Arab, and today will be this Mohammedanism, you understand, this Islamo-fascism, right, that's going on. What Dawid, some say this is Dawid here, King David, you understand, or Tahuti, what Dawid is saying, woe to I. In other words, it's like Ethiopia speaking in a sense, that Ethiopia is an island of true Judeo-Christianity, you know, since surrounded by heathen and sheathen and even some Faringe Muslimism, you know, the ones who follow after the white Muslims, you know, not the faithful black ones that came in and recognized, you know, but even some of them are being like in the Matrix, they're being turned against, you know, but be that as it may, still it's very important to understand the context. Woe is I. This is like Ethiopia crying out, being persecuted, that I sojourn in Mesech. You understand? That I dwell in the tents of Kedar. You understand? Got all this Islamo-fascism. Got the Yemen over there. Got Somalia over there. Got a couple of Christian brothers and sisters in Nubia. But then you got the Sudanese and the Ganga weed, the Janja weed, or whatever like that. Now we got Boko Hara over there. Now we got some Pakistanis and Afghanis coming in as some so-called Islamic scholars or something like that. So, you know, this is why we have the word, sound, and power, brothers and sisters. You understand? As we give thanks and praise, because this is the Son of Man, the Child of Humanity Day. You understand? Lich Teferi, the birth of Ketamawi Haile Selassie, more correctly, the manifestation of the Son of Man. We have to also recognize where we're at in the struggle. You understand? So, woe is I that sojourn in Mesech, that I dwell in the tents of Kedar. You see, they can't deny that Kedar, you understand, Kedar is part of that. Even Dr. York, he had his thing called the tents of Kedar. You understand? At first, he was saying pretty good things about His Majesty. Then all of a sudden, he started saying scunt. You understand? So this is like a woe is I. Verse 6, it says, my soul, my feeling, my thought, my will, you understand, hath long dwelt with him that hateth shalom, that hates peace. They say salam, salam alaikum, you understand, but they don't know shalom. Like I said, the way of shalom they have not known, because the way of shalom is Jesus Christos Getachin, is the Moshiach, you understand, but they have not known that. Maybe Muhammad, maybe he knew it. That's why he sent them in the Hijrah to Ethiopia. But it's clear that those after Mahmud or Muhammad have not known it, and Ethiopia's soul, in that sense, which is like the soul of Christ, have dwelt long, long dwelt with him that hateth peace. That they say salam, salam, salam. They say Islam, but they hate shalom. You understand? They hate shalom. What does it say in verse 7? I am for shalom. I am for shalom. But when I speak, they are for war. So this is a psalm of David that will help us overcome this Mohammedanism. I wouldn't say believe it or not. I would say trust and verify. Now, the next psalm is another psalm of degree. I could go through all 15 right here, but we're going to go through to the next one to show how they connect. Now, after that psalm is chanted with overstanding, with comprehension, we have Psalm 121, which is one of the fire key, one of the Ayabingi fire key psalms, if I'm correct. It says, I will lift up my eyes, my ears, to the hills. From whence cometh my help? Actually, Bamarinya is like a question right there. From where come, I will lift my eyes to the hills. From where come my help? My help cometh from Yahweh, from Jah, from He who is who He is, which made heaven and earth, or as Rastafari chanted, which built Zion and earth. He will not suffer I and I foot to be moved. You see, it's thy foot. You understand? But it's speaking to us. If we receive it as Rastafari in word, sound, and power, spirit, and truth, when we chant it, it's not thy foot. We chant it as He will not suffer I foot in collectivity. You understand? I and I foot. He will not suffer, like to say our foot. He will not suffer my foot. He will not suffer I and I foot to be moved. He that keepeth I and I will not slumber. Behold, look in sight. Look and see. Here it is. In the hole. He that keepeth Israel. He that keepeth I and I, Beta Israel, black Israel, shall neither slumber nor sleep. Yahweh is I and I keeper. Yahweh is I and I shade upon I and I right hand. The sun, the S-U-N, the Sahai, the Thai, shall not smite I and I by day, nor the moon by night. Yahweh shall preserve I and I from all evil. He shall preserve I and I soul. Yahweh shall preserve I and I going out and I and I coming in from this time forth, from this Iowa forward, and even for Iver more. Amen. 1, 2, 2. Just one more. 1, 2, 2. We might just narrow it right here on 1, 2, 2. Right? A song of degrees of David. The other ones don't say David, but this one clearly says David. You understand? Or Dawid. Or Dawit. Or Tehuti, if you want to take it to the mysteries. If you want to go to the root in ancient Egypt, that's Tehuti or Dawit. It says here, verse 1, I was glad. What were we glad? You understand? Who makes you glad? You got to be glad. You understand? In a sense, it's almost like a commandment. Be glad. But if you don't want to be glad, then be sad. But the psalm says, I was glad when they said to me, when they said to I, let us, make I and I go into the house, the bait of Ikiziyahir, of Yahweh, of He who is who He is, the house of the King of Kings, the house of the true and living God, Father of our black Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. I and I feet, our feet, shall stand within thy gates, O Jerusalem, O Jerusalem. Jerusalem is builded as a city that is compact together. Addis Ababa is built as a city that is compact together. Whither? Where? The tribes go up. Which tribes? Speaking about the 12 tribes, I and I. The tribes go up. The tribes of Yahweh. The tribes of Ikiziyahir. The tribe of the Lord, if you please. To the what? The testimony. To testify. Shema Yisroel. Yahweh Eloheinu. Yahweh Achad. To testify. The testimony of Israel. Ani me'amin ki Yeshua HaMoshiach Bein HaElohim Hu. I bear witness like the Ethiopian eunuch that Jesus Christos is the Son of God, to give thanks, Yankfu, thanks and Isis, to the name, to the Shem, you understand, to the Hashem of Yahweh, of He who is who He is, and that name, Kedamawi, Haile Selassie, Haile Selassie first. For there, where? For there is set thrones of judgment, the thrones of the house of David, of DVD, of David, of Dawit, great King David. Pray. This is what we ought to do. Pray, right? To pray, right? Pray for what? To pray for the peace of Jerusalem, even the new Jerusalem, Jerusalem. They that prosper, they shall prosper. They shall do what? They shall prosper that love thee. Those who hate the New Jerusalem, those who hate Addis Ababa, who hate Ethiopia, you understand, who hate the King of Kings, who hate I and I, they should not prosper. Why should they? You understand? Why do they hate? But it says, pray for the peace of Jerusalem. They shall prosper that love thee. Now, when you read this in the language, it's in the female, feminine sense. So Jerusalem is taken as she. You understand, taken as she. So understand that context in this series of reasoning of the word for the 23rd. You heard? All right. Peace be within thy walls. And what? Prosperity within thy palaces. You see, what a lot of folks, the Pharisees and Sadducees try to do, they try to take the prosperity out of here. You understand? And leave us busted. You understand? Without even knowing our identity, our nationhood. You understand? So when we recognize who we are as a nation, they're trying to cut us off from being a nation. And we recognize, well, who is our God? Who is our Messiah? You understand? What is the revelation of Rastafari? Then that brings that prosperity, that brings that unity, that brings that sustainability all into reality. You can't do it through no kind of little secular ways, little secular ways. You can't do it that way. You have to do it Jah's way or it won't be done. Peace be within thy walls and prosperity within thy palaces, even Jubilee Palace. Verse 8, for my brethren and companions' sake. Does it say for the heathen and sheathen in the world, you know, and stupid people? No. It says for my brethren. For my brethren. You know what I'm saying? For my, who is my brethren? You know that teaching. One who does the will of my father, the same is my brother, my mother, and my sister. You know what I'm saying? Everyone else cut off. For my brethren and companions' sake, I will now say, peace be within thee. May peace be within Addis Ababa, our Jerusalem. May peace be within our holy city. Verse 9, because of what? Because of what do we say this? It's because of the house, the bait of the Lord, of Yahweh, our God, of Yahweh Eloheinu, or in Revelation, Rastafari Targum, of He who is who He is, our Father, our Abba, because of His house, I will seek thy good. We will seek thy good. My brothers and sisters, oh, this is beautiful right here, but there's more. I mean, these songs of degrees are vital keys. Each one of them. Let's square this. When I say square this, let's deal with four. We dealt with three. Let's deal with four. Let's deal with 1, 2, 3. Right? 1, 2, 3. Right? This message is Rastafari reality. So a song of degrees. Right? Verse 1, 2, 3. The fourth psalm of degrees. Now, you see, it says unto. You remember that, but the un. Un mean not to. Word, sound, and power. Don't say the un. Say to. To thee. You understand? Undone, unclean. You know, you get it? So when you say unto, see, that's a little trick knowledge they put there. Cut off the un. Say to. To thee. You understand? To thee, lift I up mine eyes, O thou that dwellest in the heavens. Behold, as the eyes of the servants look to the hand of their masters, as the eyes of a maiden to the hand of her mistress, so our eyes wait upon Yahweh, our Elohim, or Yahweh Eloheinu, or He who is our Father, until that He have mercy upon us, until that He, Abba Tachin, Kedus Abba Tachin, have mercy on us. Have mercy upon us, Avitu, I Father, His Father, O Father of the house. Have mercy upon I and I, for we are exceedingly filled with contempt. The world deals with Rastafari and I and I reality and Ethiopian Hebrew peoples contemptuously. We're full of their contempt. Our soul is exceedingly filled with the scorning, for their scorning and all their yawning at the truth of those that are at ease. See, they're at ease. That's why they don't want things to change. They recognize this truth, but they don't want that to get out because that's gonna mess with their easy, their comfort zone. Right? Check this out. Verse 4. Our soul is exceedingly filled with the scorning of those that are at ease. With the scorning, those who scorn are those who are at what? At ease. And with the contempt of the proud. Of the proud. This is beautiful here. One more, right? 1, 2, 4. A song of degrees of David. If it had not been Yahweh, He who is who He is, who was on our side, now may Israel say, if it had not been Yahweh who was on our side when men and Pope Paul rose up against I and I, then they had swallowed us up quick when their wrath, their wrath, was kindled against us. Then the waters had overwhelmed us. You remember Revelation chapter 12 about the water of the serpent that comes out against the woman. Then the waters had overwhelmed us. The stream had gone over our soul. Over our soul. They want to flood out I and I soul, I and I psyche. Then the proud waters, what kind of waters are they? Proud waters had gone over I and I soul. Blessed be Yahweh, Baruch Atah Yahweh, who hath not given us as a prey to their teeth. He has not given us as some piece of meat for them to eat. Yehovah's, our soul, I and I soul, Nefsachin, is escaped as a bird out of the snare of the fowlers. The snare, get this, the snare is broken. Babylon is busted. Babylon is broken. And we and I are escaped. Our help is in the name. Get that? Our help is in what? It's in the Shem, the Hashem. Our help is in the name of Yahweh. Our help is in the Hashem of He who is who He is, Kedemawi, Haile Selassie first, who made heaven and earth. Amen and amen. 1, 2, 5. Let's just keep going through this right here. A song of degrees. They that trust in Yahweh, He who is who He is, shall be as what? Mount Zion, Mount Zion, which cannot be removed. You see, they talk about a revolution, they overthrew Haile Selassie, yeah, whatever you want to talk about. But they that trust in the King of Kings shall be as Mount Zion, which cannot be removed, but abideth forever. You understand? See, we see it, but they can't see it. As the mountains are round about Jerusalem, so Yahweh, the King of Kings, He who is who He is round about His people. For from henceforth, even forever. Check this out, verse 3. For the rod of the wicked, the rod of the weak-hearted, shall not rest upon the lot of the righteous. Lest, unless the righteous put forth their hands to do iniquity, unless the righteous put forward their hand to do rebellion. You understand? To be a rebellion. You understand? Verse 4. Do good. Do good. Do good. Do good. That's the harps. It's the heartbeat. Do good, Abetu. I, father, his father, O father of the house, to those that be good. And to them that are upright in what? In their hearts, that are straightforward, don't have no hypocrisy in their hearts. As for such as turn aside to their crooked ways, in Iabingi we would say this like this, as for such as turn aside to their crook-hearted ways, Yahweh shall lead them. Get this part. Yahweh shall lead them. In Revelation, the King of Kings shall lead them forth with the workers of iniquity, with the workers of rebellion. So why did His Majesty resist that rebellion? He didn't have to resist that evil. You understand? He led them forth with the workers of iniquity. But peace, shalom, shalom, it says, shall be upon true Israel. Shalom is upon the Beta Israel. 126, Song of Degrees. When Yahweh turned again the captivity of Sion, we were like them that dream. Then was our mouth filled with laughter. When he turned that captivity, we had to laugh. You know what I'm saying? Our tongue was singing. Our tongue was song and singing, right? Was singing. Then said they among the heathen, then the goys and the gals, they said, Yahweh. They said, Jah have done great things for them. Yah have done great things for I and I, whereof we are glad, we are happy. Turn again our captivity. You understand? Turn again this captivity. Bottom rail on top, Masa. Abetu, O father, his father, O father of the house, as the streams in the south. Now notice where the streams come from in the south. Need we show you a map again? Lake Victoria Falls, where the streams come actually from the south, as the streams in the south. You get it? Coming up to Ethiopia, then to Egypt, then draining in the Mediterranean, all right, in the Middle Earth, draining into the Middle Earth as the streams in the south. They that sow in tears, even I and I ancestors for 400 plus years, right? They that sow in tears shall reap in joy. So all those tears for all those years, we're coming to the time of reaping and reaping in joy. You're reaping in joy and in joy. He that goeth forth and weepeth, bearing precious seed, shall doubtless, so Father, doubt, no doubt, a goatee, no doubt, come again with rejoicing, bringing his sheaves with him. 127. 127, let's just go through this. The Holy Spirit is with I and I. Let's go through this. A Song of Degrees for Suleiman or Shlomo or for us, Solomon. Except Yahweh build the house, unless he build the bait, the Beta Rastafari. They labor in vain that build it. So if ones and ones are going to do a Rasta thing and not do it on His Majesty's teaching, they're just wasting their time. They labor in vain that build it. Except the King of Kings, Yahweh, Ekziabi, Herlotu, Sabhat, keepeth the city. Unless the King of Kings keep Addis Ababa, the watchman waketh but in vain. It is vain for you to rise up early, to sit up late, to eat the bread of sorrows. Remember, we're talking about that word sorry. I'm sorry, sorry, sorry. No, he bore our sorrow. He carried our sorrow. You understand? So those things are done. You understand? It's vain for you to rise up early, to sit up late, to eat the bread of sorrows, for so he giveth his beloved sleep. You understand? So he gives I and I rest and sleep. Lo, look, look, children are an heritage of Yahweh, of Ekziabihir, and the fruit of the womb is his reward. You check that? The fruit of the womb is not, this is my child. It's, no, the fruit of the womb in covenant is his reward. He's given you a reward. As arrows are in the hand of a mighty man, so are children of the youth. You see, and but people, they be cursing. Babies having, babies, baby having. See, because these are a bunch of heathen. Ribbling and rabbling, dibbling and dabbling, bunch of heathen. Jah word says, as arrows are in the hand of a mighty man, so are the children of the youth. Happy is the man that hath his quiver full of them. In other words, like in the old days, it's like having enough ammunition. In other words, your quiver full of them. They shall not be ashamed. They will not be ashamed, but they shall speak with the enemies in the gate. In the gate. You know, the enemies ain't getting in, but they'll talk to the enemies in the gate. Right? 1:2:8. Baruch. Blessed is everyone that reverenceth or feareth Yahweh, that walketh in his way. For thou shalt eat the labor of thine hands. Happy Asher shall thou be, and it shall be well with thee. Thy wife shall be as a fruitful vine by the sides of thine house. Thy children like olive plants round about thy table. Behold, look and see that thus shall the man be blessed that reverenceth Yahweh. Yahweh shall bless thee out of Sion, and thou shalt see the good of Jerusalem all the days of thy life. Yea, thou shalt see thy children's children, and what? Shalom upon Israel. Shalom upon the black Israel, upon Ionai, Beta Israel. 1:9, a psalm of degrees. Many a time have they afflicted Ionai from Ionai youth. May Israel now say, they've been afflicting us, Satan, the devil been trying to afflict us from long time now. Many a time have they afflicted Ionai from Ionai youth, yet they have not prevailed against Ionai. The plow was plowed upon my back, Ionai back. They whipped and beat the black man slaves, like in that movie Passion of the Christ, when they're beating Christ. That's how they've been beating black man ever since. And the black Christ that they beat, that's how they beat him. But people get caught up on the whitewash image. But still, the plow was plowed upon my back. They made long their furrows, made long scars. You ever see that picture of the slave that has his back turned and he's posing? You see all of those furrows, just like the fields, those lines across the field. That's what it's saying right there. Yahweh is righteous. The King of Kings is righteous. He has cut asunder the cords of the wicked. The wicked is all cut up right now, but they're using psyops. They're using psychological tricks. And because most people are not admitting Jah's word and accepting his revelation, they're easy to be caught up, hoodwinked, bamboozled, so forth and so on. Make them all be confounded and turn back that hate Zion. All those that hate the African Zion, all those that hate Zion, may they be turned back and confused and bump into walls. Who cares? Make them be as the grass upon the housetop, which withereth afore it groweth up, because when that sun come up, it burn them. Wherewith the mower filleth not his hand, nor he that bindeth sheaves his bosom, because it's worthless grass. They leave it there. They let the sun burn it up. There's no value in it. They leave it there. That's what that verse there means. Verse 8, neither do they which go by say, the blessing of Yahweh be upon you. We bless you in the name of Yahweh. This is interesting. It's like the part in John. I think it's the second epistle of John where it says that not to say Godspeed on those who don't carry the doctrine or the teaching of his majesty and his Christ, otherwise you be partaker of their evil deeds. It's showing you what a blessing is, but these ones don't get that blessing. 1:30. Let's go to 1:30. Right? 1:30 says, out of the depths have I cried to thee, Abitu. Adoni, hear my voice. May thine ears be attentive to the voice of my supplication. If thou art thereto, should mark iniquities, rebellion art thereto, who shall stand? That's why that prayer says that we should pray always to be found worthy to stand before the Son of Man. But there is forgiveness, hallelujah, with thee, that thou mayest be feared in the sense of be reverenced. I wait for Yahweh. My soul doth wait, and in his word do I hope. You see, so we hope, but we hope, we expect what? We expect his word to be true. That's what it means. In his word do I hope. In his word do we expect. My soul waiteth for Adonai more than they that watch for the morning. I say, more than they that watch for the morning. May Israel hope in Jah. For with Jah there is mercy, and with him is plenteous redemption. And he shall redeem Israel from all his iniquity. He shall clean us up. He shall get us right. It's for us to turn to him willingly. You understand? Make our wills obedient to good influences. 131, a song of the degrees of David. Abetu, my heart is not haughty, nor my eyes lofty, neither do I exercise myself in great matters, or in things too high for me. Surely I have behaved and quieted myself as a child that is weaned of his mother. My soul is even as a weaned child. May Israel hope in Jah from henceforth and forever. Psalm 132, a song of degrees. Lord, Abetu, I father, his father, O father of the house, remember David, remember great King David and all his afflictions, how he swore to Jah and vowed to the mighty God of Jacob, surely I will not come into the tabernacle of my house, nor go up into my bed. I will not give sleep to mine eyes, nor slumber to my eyelids, until I find a place for Jah, and habitation for the mighty God of Jacob. Lo, look, we have heard of it in Ephrata. We found it in the field of the wood. What did they find? We will go into his tabernacles. We will worship at his footstool. Arise, Abetu, into thy rest, thou and the ark of thy strength. This was said when the ark was going forward. Arise, Abetu, into thy rest, thou and the tabot, the ark of thy strength. May thy priests be clothed with righteousness. May I and I, as Jah's new millennium priest, the order of Melchizedek, be clothed with his son, with Yeshua HaMoshiach, our black Lord and Savior. For he alone is I and I, righteous man. And may thy saints, the Kedusan, shout for joy. For thy servant Dawit's sake, turn not away the face of thine anointed. Yahweh have sworn in truth to David. He will not turn from it. Of the fruit of thy body will I set upon thy throne. Kedamawi Haile Selassie, you know, I see it. You know, over is this psalm right here. You understand? Of the fruit of David's body. Right, he says, the Lord hath sworn in truth to David, he will not turn from it. Of the fruit of thy body will I sit upon thy throne. If thy children will keep my covenant, if, the key word, if we will keep the Kal Kidan, if we will keep the Benai Berit, if, you understand, if, it's your choice. If thy children will keep my covenant and my testimony, notice, my covenant and my testimony, the two truths. My covenant and my testimony that I shall teach them, Their children shall also sit upon thy throne forever. This is important for the restoration of the monarchy. For Yahweh hath chosen Zion. Jah has chosen Zion. He hath desired it for his habitation. Jah has desired it for his own dwelling place. This is my rest. This is my rest forever. Here will I dwell, for I have desired it. I will abundantly bless her provision. You know what that means? That means there will be no starvation and famine. That only occurred because of the rebellion, because of the iniquity, because of the turning the back on the covenant and on God's elect. But he says that if we do these things, he will abundantly bless, multiply her provision. I will satisfy her poor with bread. I will also clothe her priest with salvation, with Yeshua. You know what it says in the New Testament, in Revelation, so that they be not naked. Naked means they don't have that righteousness. Naked means they don't have Yeshua. They have not put on Yeshua. You know what I'm saying? So they're naked. They may be wearing long robes or whatever like that, but in Jah's sight, they're naked. I will also clothe her priests with salvation, and her saints, her kedusanwa, shall shout aloud. For what? For joy. For joy. For happiness. For gladness of heart. There will I make the horn of David to bud. I have ordained a lamp, a light, illumination for mine anointed. For my Christ, for my Moshiach. His enemies, the enemies of the King of Kings and his Christ, will I clothe with shame. They'll clothe with shame. But upon himself, Berasu, shall his crown, let me show you this right here, shall his crown, and no Burger King crown, but the real crown, shall his crown flourish. Look at that. Shall his crown flourish. You see that psalm? See that living word right there? This is reality. These are pictures right here that are painted by man. This is the living man. You're over saying this is Christ in his kingly character. Our woe, our woe. Okay, let's complete this right here. Let's complete this right here. We got two more. These are the 15. These are 15 psalms and chants and, you know, psalms of praises for a time like this, which remembers and commemorates and celebrates the son of the man-child, the coming of the man-child, the son of man, Lich Teferi, what's often called the earth day or the birthday of Kedamawi Haile Selassie, but actually in spirit and in truth, Haile Selassie, he was not born. Lich Teferi, he was born. But Father is merciful. He knows that ones are still growing into the knowledge and the mystery of God in Christ. 133, a song of degrees of David. Behold, look and see how good and how pleasant it is for brethren, Wendemoch, to dwell together in unity, ba'andnet, bechibret. It is like the precious ointment upon the ras, upon the head, that ran down upon the beard, even Aharon's beard, that went down to the skirts of his garments, as the dew of Hermon, and as the dew that descended upon the mountains of Zion. For there Yahweh Jah, he who is who he is, the King of Kings, commanded the Bereket, the Burake, the blessing, even life forevermore. Get that. For there Yahweh, for there Jah, for there he who is who he is, he commanded the Bereket, He commanded the blessing. He commanded the burake. He commanded it. Commanded it. The hand sign of blessing. He commanded the baraket. Baruch Ata Adonai. Even life forevermore. So what was the blessing that he commanded? Even life forevermore. 1, 3, 4 to complete the songs of degrees. Behold, Ineho, Ineho, Bamarinya, is Ineho in Hebrew, Hine, Hine, Ineho, Ineho. Behold, look and see, here it is, here he is. Bless ye Jah, bless ye Yah, bless ye Yahweh, bless ye Egziabihur Lotus of Hat, all ye servants of the sustainer of Egziabihur of Yahweh, which by night stand the Amidah prayer, stand in the house of Yahweh. Lift up your hands. Lift up your hands in the sanctuary, in the Mekdes, and bless Baruch, Baruch, and bless Jah, and bless Yahweh, bless the King of Kings and His Christ. Yahweh that made heaven and earth, bless you all, my brothers and sisters, out of Zion. Shalom in the home of Rastafari. Salam.